So good evening, everyone. And today is the third day of our series, the basic understanding of mineral series. In last two sessions, I have told you that how to understand that whether this patient belongs to mineral kingdom or not. And in the second session, we did the details about roles. That what is periodic table, you know, how Jan Scholten has developed this idea, how Dr. Sankaran has developed this idea, and what are the details of the roles. And also I have given you two homeworks, and I want to tell you that very few people have sent me email, so I expect more from you. Please do your homework, it will definitely help you. It's not because, you know, I just want you to do the homework. I just want you to understand minerals properly. If you're attending the session, it should benefit you. Because if it doesn't benefit you, if you only listen and go home, that doesn't work. And it doesn't help you. It's just a waste of time. And if you really want to, you know, understand it, please do your homework. Just try to experience how mineral can think, how mineral can behave. And then you'll get into the soul of the mineral. Okay, so you have to think that way. Okay, so we will start today's talk. And in today's talk, I'm going to talk about columns. So far you know the row thing, and now you're going to learn about the minerals. So yes, Dr. Vijay and Kashyap Chawla said that they have missed the two last sessions. So yes, we have already uploaded them on YouTube. You can go and watch the video. Just watch the video, do your homework, and do send me the email. Okay, and try to concentrate on what I am teaching today. Just a minute. Yeah, okay. So this is a session 3 of columns. Now we will see what columns says, and before that I want you to have a look on how periodic table or the minerals look like. Okay. So this is a mineral chart. Okay. And this is by Jan Scholten. Though everybody uses this chart only, the understanding is different. So I told you that, you know, the 6 rows or 7 rows of periodic table also belongs to the development of life. You can correlate the rows with how a human being develops. Similarly, the columns also have some particular characteristics where, you know, you can relate them with the capability of getting success, maintaining success, and giving up the success. Okay, so on extreme left of the periodic table, of the columns, you will see incapable of success. So they are completely incapable. They don't have the capacity. So I just want to tell you that there are 18 columns. This is a basic chemistry you must be knowing. So on the extreme left, they are not capable at all of success. In the left side, little left, they try for getting the success. In the middle, they are successful. So all the remedies are successful, stable. You know, they have the stable bonds. On the right side, when you move ahead of 10th column, you will see maintaining of success. And on extreme right, giving up success. Okay. Okay. So, can you see this picture? If yes, then you just have to, you know, take note of this picture for sure. I will tell you what is the importance of this. Just a minute. Okay, I will tell you in the last. You have to just keep this mountain in the mind. Okay, so from left to right, the capacity increases. and then again decreases. So when you are going from first column to 10th column, the capacity to do anything, you know, like I told you in the third row, they think about love, care and nourishment. So from left to right or to the middle, the capacity is slowly increasing, and on the right side of the columns, right side of the row, in the columns, the capacity will decrease. So we will talk about individual columns now. So column one, okay, so on the stage of success, column one doesn't have any foundation, you know. You should remember all the remedies which comes in column one, like hydrogen. Okay, so there is no foundation, no structure. They are totally dependent on the structure outside and feels that it is their own. Okay, so the outside structure is their own structure. So they are that dependent that they, you know, they are not able to differentiate between it is their structure or somebody else's structure. They are too much dependent. And if challenged, what will happen? So this is an anxiety. This is column one. So on column two, foundation is very, very weak. You know, they think that I can have my own structure, but if slightest challenge comes, they would run for help. They go ahead, but always need people. So they would always need, you know, support and guidance. This is column two. So they begin, you know, to feel the presence of structure. But it is a, Dr. Shankaran always says that it is a provisional structure, just like, you know, tent. So you go in tent, you might, you know, stay there for some time, but tent is not forever. So you have to, you know, need support, just like a tent, which serves the purpose only as long as conditions are optimal, not for forever. If things are a little out of the way, then immediately they need permanent structure. That is column two. And the keywords for column two will be support, backing, dependence, encouragement, and lack of confidence. Just like in, you know, calcarea, you will see in other remedies also. You will see in column two. Now, if we go further to column three. Column three has, it's a very, you know, starting of getting the success. So in column three, you will see a lot of confusion, a lot of doubt. So they are certain about the presence of foundation. Neev hai abhi unke paas. Foundation is there, but still they are uncertain about the type of structure they have. So they don't have the tent right now, but they have the foundation, but abhi bhi pura ghar khada nahi hua hai. The whole structure is not still, you know, yet confirmed. So they are very, very not sure, confused type of. You can see this in alumina. Alumina is column three. So, you know, there's a lot of doubt and confusion and hesitation and unsureness that I'm not sure. You know, alumina, you must have read that there is a symptom of confusion. They cannot decide anything. That is column three. Now, if you go to column four has a good foundation now, a firm foundation, but still the structure is in progress. So you are building up the structure. I know the type of structure, but uncertain about its sturdiness. So column, yahan par agar if you are making a house, you just, you know, imagine a house where there is a foundation built up, but there are columns which now you're going to build up on which the whole house will be, you know, built, but still you are unsure about the sturdiness. So this structure is inadequate structure, and they would always think that, you know, my own structure will be resolved. There is no stepping back or going back. So one has to do the things on their own. But the question is that does one have the ability to do so? And then there is feeling of inadequacy. So here the main keyword or main question is, will I be able to do that? Okay, that is column four. Keywords may be beginning, starting off, taking off, incapacity, inadequacy, lack of confidence, like this. So in column four, the question is, will I be able to do this or not? So a lot of inadequacy. Okay, so if we go to column five, the column five has a good foundation, a good structure. They are very sure of the structure, sure of the sturdiness, but Now, will the structure function actually? Unsure about the functionality. So the foundations are not strong. It postpones, you know, postpones everything because they don't know whether it would function or not, whether it is, you know, capable enough to hold on or not. So they would always think that, do I have the ability or not? Should I go ahead or should I not? That's the question. So here the keywords are unsure, not sure, postpone, and you know, a lot of postponement you will see. They would postpone everything because they always feel that they are not prepared enough, and there is lack of confidence and hesitation and a lot of practice. You will see a lot of practice in column 5, column 6. If they don't do it, they will fail. Success and failures are two keys they use a lot. I will fail and I will be blamed for it. Inadequate to face the challenges. So preparing and postponing. So if we go to column 6, of course, the structure is not yet complete, but test it. Okay, it's not complete, but yes, it is there. It is able to function. But it is compelled to face the challenge. So proving comes here. You know, you have to prove, you have to face the challenges, the risks. You have to be very cautious. Otherwise, you know that structure is not fully ready, fully equipped, but you know, one has to go ahead, take a plunge with their limitation, take chances. And that is column 6. The column 6 keywords may be proof, proving, prove myself, daring, run a risk, show them, take risk, take chances, something like that. If we move little ahead towards column 7, there is no issue of foundation at all, because the foundation is there, the structure is fully complete, I am complete, but is it going to work? Still the question remains that yes, now, okay, I am complete, but not go full blast. So a lot of preparation comes here also. So from 5 to 7, you will see lot and lot of preparation and proving also. And the risk factor has increased a lot. So structure is adequate in normal conditions. In normal conditions, I'm telling you, but it needs support in tough condition, in challenging conditions, and one does not need to prove anymore. Like in column 6, you need to prove that, you know, your structure is stable. Now there is no need, but there is a need of refining, fine tuning and improving. So reinforcement, bolstering, fortify, improving, enhancing, polishing, and all these words come here. Polishing is very important. How far one can grow, how much more they can do, upgrading, you know, they take a lot of feedbacks, they test their skills. That is column 7. Yeah, so column 7 is, I know I can do it, but when there is difficult time, tough time, challenges or opposition, how much can I bear? No sudden movements. So though I am ready, but you know, if something big comes to my life or to my situation, I won't be able to handle that. Or I don't know whether I would be able to handle or not. Need to be very cautious and careful and held back. So column 8 is a very stable column, I would say, and there is no issues of foundation. Perseverance is the main theme of this column. Perseverance, persist. So persist with it in spite of faults or opposition. So if some, you know, if even the challenge comes, if even someone says anything, if someone does anything, I am not going to break now. So resistance, firmness, determination, and strong will is there. So there is a lot of strong will. This is a Farum column, guys. So Farum comes in this column. So you have to, you know iron very well. And iron is a very, very strong metal, you know, which persists in spite of heat, in spite of, it has a very high melting point. So that's the quality, resistance, firmness, determination. So in column 8, the structure is proved. There is no longer a challenge, but the structure has to resist a very, very high pressure. I have to go against resistance, pressure, and opposition, and they have to stand firm. So I'm complete. I have been careful and cautious. You're not going to shake me now. Perseverance is the word, like I told you. Column 9. So column 9 is, I'm near success. But what if I make a mistake? What if I don't succeed? You know, when we go for some exam, when we appear for the interview, and when we are fully ready, we are just entering the examination hall, sometimes we just get fainted. Sometimes we just, think that whether I would be able to crack this exam or not, whether I would be able to get good marks or not, whether I would be able to write or not. So, when you are completely ready, but just before appearing into exam or just before appearing to that challenge which is coming to you, you will have that self-doubt. I have experienced this many times that, patients come to you and they would tell you that, doctor, when I was going on stage to perform, I just felt that now I cannot sing at all, cannot talk at all. So this is column 9. Just, a little self-doubt about whether they will be able to do that thing or not. So they can face challenges well, they are well prepared, but there is the last minute anxiety is there. That is column 9. So in column 9, structure is almost near perfect, not exactly perfect, but almost perfect, but little short. So the keywords could be, absolute, am I really good, complete, or they would say, doctor, I have failed miserably. I can't tell you how I felt. I was so close to success. I was so close to, get this contract, and I didn't get it. Last minute, they told me that, no, you're not eligible for this. So, this type of cases. Column 9, finishing touch wale cases. So this is column 10. We call it summit column. They are successful. They have their own structure, which is very strong and functioning well. And they are capable to face the challenges. But they require maintenance. So the structure is complete, very successful. So the keywords will be success, failure, achievements, high, and appreciation, and like this. This is column 10. So silica comes here. Platina comes here, all these remedies. So now we reach to column 10. So column 10, you can just take column 10 as a middle column because we have like 18 columns. So 9 or 10 are almost similar. And a lot of people have, taken 10 as a summit column. Okay. So now this is from left to middle, and now we will go from middle to right side. So column 11 is little on the right side of the row. So on the right side, like I told you, until now you are gaining the capacity. So on column 10th, or even you can say on 9th, you have got that capacity or capability to perform anything or to take the responsibility or to provide love, care, or nourishment according to rules, anything. But from column 11, now the structure is subjected to test and repeatedly it faces the attacks and challenges. See, the similarity between the left side and right side is that they both face the challenges, the attacks. But on the left side, they are doubtful whether they have the capability or not. And on the right side, they are losing the capacity. Are you getting my point? That, this left side, they don't have the capacity. On right side, they had the capacity, but now they're losing it. So repeatedly facing the attacks and challenges, maintaining is the big problem in 11th column. So Argentum comes here, the silver series, the fifth series. So Argentum have to face a lot of attacks and lot of challenges. Structure stands by itself. Will it maintain itself in adverse condition? That's the question. And whether they would be able to defend or not, that's the problem. So keyword can be maintain. Maintain is the big keyword here. Control, defense, defend, critical, performance, you know, that type of keywords come here. So if we go to column 12, little more on the right side, the structure comes in the crisis here, because structure is attacked constantly, more often than the 11th one, and you need to make a lot of efforts to maintain it. It is very difficult. Struggle is very high. So unsuccessful efforts, yeah? There is a lot of threat. So there is constant attack on the structure, constant fight to prevent it from being damaged, constant vigilance is there, and constant state of alertness. So they you know, they start having enemies now. So I guess this mercury also comes in column 12. Yes, so mercury and zincum. So you know, zincum has this fidgety feeling, mercury is very syphilitic. So HT comes in this column 12, where you know there's a lot of feeling of I am in danger, there are enemies, they are going to rob me, and like this. So unsuccessful. Now, if we go a little on the right side, column 13, redundancy. So what is redundant? The structure is under severe attack, the loss is imminent, and it needs superhuman effort to sustain or to maintain. The structure is there, but it is useless. So your structure is attacked and you make many unsuccessful efforts, then you start giving up, you know. There is no maintaining anymore. Gallium and indium type of remedies come here. You just start giving up. Column 14. In column 14, there is a constant threat of destruction of the structure. They are attacked and losing the structure. So, you know, in last column also we have said, we have seen that there is no structure, almost no structure. So they feel empty in column 14 because the structure is lost, the destruction has happened. So they would feel empty, extremely weak and drained, and a paralytic weakness comes here. So, you know, in column 14, you will see a remedy like plumbum and stanum. Stanum and plumbum also comes in column 14. And you must have seen that plumbum has a lot of paralysis. Stanum has, you know, the stanum cough in which they are not able to breathe, not able to talk out of cough. They cough and just give up. They say that now I cannot even talk to you after coughing so much. That is paralytic weakness, because the structure is completely gone, completely empty. That is column 14. Column 15. So column 15 is same. The structure is breaking. They are losing it. And they have realized that, yes, I have lost it. And now they have to be very, very careful. Why? Because jo bhi tha, usko bach, jo bhi tha, wo gaya. Ab jitna bhi kuch hai, little bit, usko bachana hai. Whatever they are remained with, they have to save that. So they are very weak to preserve it. They cannot depend on others, and they feel, you know, that loneliness, because their structure is not only broken, it is eroded. The structure is completely eroded, it is falling apart, and its integrity cannot be preserved. So they are very careful and see how much and for how long it can be preserved. That is column 15. And in column 15, you will say remedies like arsenic, which is extremely cautious, extremely careful, and lot of fear of death, because they know now they are going to die. When they don't know. So they have to be that much cautious. You know, people near to death, what they do? They're extremely cautious about things, because they know, they can see that now the death is nearing. That's the thing of column 15. And the keywords for column 15 is eroding, damaging, anguish, run like this. Column 16. So in column 16, they have lost the structure, lost it completely, and they are alone to face it. Okay. So column 16, the loss of capacity, energy, and ability. So keywords are no capacity, no energy. They are very incapable, not possible to work at all, indifference, and they are also forgetful. So in column 16, you will see sulfur, oxygen, like these remedies. Okay. And now comes column 17, that is completely opposite. Because though you are alive, but you are alone to face it. So you have seen all the hardships of your life. You have lost your structure. You don't have anything. You cannot ask help from others. So, you know, you feel inside somewhere in the soul, you feel betrayed and let down. So they really feel betrayed and they feel, ab koi matlab nahi. Now I'm not going to, you know, listen to anyone. I'm completely opposite. I would do whatever they say and I would do exactly opposite of them. That's the thing. So halogens. Halogens are very important remedies. In salts and even alone, they are very, very important remedies. So the structure is dissolving and crumbling. They feel starved. They feel betrayed, you know, and they feel disappointed and trapped and alone to face it. And the keywords can be also same, like crumbling, betrayed, let down, disappointed, trapped, and confined, and escape, and like all these things. That's why, you know, if you see natrum mure, chlorine comes in column 17, which is a halogen. So if you see natrum mure has a lot of, you know, let down feeling, disappointed in love, betrayed in love. They feel that because they have the column 17 features into that. Okay, so column 18 is a you know, complete column or finished column, I would say. And you all know already that it is noble gases. They are known as noble gases. So feeling is, I am through with it. Abhi ho gaya mera. I am through with success and failure, through with whatever was happening in my life or whole stage. So there is no question of success or failure. They are above all these things. They are just noble, not affected by anything at all. So structure is completely dissolved or there is no structure and they are not bothered about it. So we don't know much about column 18. I have never prescribed anything from neon gases. So I don't know. I won't be able to give you that much information because I have no experience, frankly. But yes, you can read about them in Dr. Shankaran's book or Dr. Jan Charlton's book, and you will get more information. I only know that they have this type of feeling that it doesn't matter for me. Okay, so so guys, we have 6 minutes left. I want to show you something which I showed you in the starting. Okay, if you remember, I told you that, you know, you keep this mountain in mind. So can anyone tell me the importance of this? According to you, why I said that? Yes. Ascending, Divya. Okay. Growth of mountains, ages, Shalini. Nitin said it indicates the stages of life. Smita, stages. Okay. Dark in front and blurred on later. Very nice. Hiding. Dr. Aishwarya said up and down. 1 to 8 ascending. Very nice. Very nice. Thank you so much. So you got my point. But you know, you have to don't just read columns by whatever is written or you know, from the books. Of course, read from the books, they are very important, but you have to, you know, understand it through a point of view of a mountain. So you know, if you know any mountain or if you have hiked or done this mountain climbing, you must have seen, you know, initially what happens. I just give the example of Himalaya. So if someone wants to go to peak of Himalaya, say Everest, okay? So if you take an example of Everest, though this is a picture of Everest only, Himalayan mountain. So if one wants to go to Everest, what they do initially, you know, they know that I don't have the capacity. Okay, so they just start developing their physical capacity. They go on training and training and training, and there is minimum, you know, 4 to 6 months of training they give for to all the mountaineers to go for this Everest climbing. And you know, when you are at the bottom of the mountain, any mountain, you feel that, you know, how I'm going to climb this? This is so difficult. I'm not going to do this. But then you have this feeling of, you know, gaining the capacity. So then you think, okay, chalo, let's try it. And then you start it. So from the first and second column, the feeling is, okay, let's gain the capacity to climb it. And as you go further and further and further, and you reach to the base camp of the Mount Everest, you know, base camp is like very high. It's a base of the peak. Yeah, why it is called as base camp? Because it's not the base of the mountain, it's the base of the peak. So when you reach to the base camp, you are almost in the seventh or eighth column. And in the seventh or eighth column, you feel that, you know, I'm almost done. I am like, I am there, but still there are a lot of challenges, a lot of, you know, the problems you will be facing, the winds, the rain and the ice, and there are many problems. So you will face it, and then you will see that when you are at column 8, that is, you know, the ferrum, if you take an example of ferrum or iron, on column 8 you think that I'm almost there, but I'm not exactly there, so I have to face the challenge. So then you keep going and going and going, and you are just near the peak, and you think, you know, now I can fail. That's ninth column. And when you are at the top, the first thing which comes to a mountaineer's mind on Everest is, now whether I will be able to sustain here or not, maintain my breathing here or not. And you know, people, you know, guys, I will tell you that most of the people in mountaineering, they die or they lose their breath when they come down. It's not when they go up. When you go up, you don't die. But when you come down, because you have lost all the capacities, you have lost your structure, you have just, you know, completed or finished your oxygen cylinder. So that's the problem there. And when you're on 9, you're at success peak, you're very happy, that's fine. But maintenance is the problem. And then you come, you start, you know, you're going down, coming to the base again. And that is the right side of the column. So you can just remember this mountain or remember this mountain climbing, and you will understand different stages of columns. Okay. So I can read your messages. It increases up to some, yes. So Prashant sir has written that Arjandam is look like in column 9, near to success, anxiety, self-doubt, with all other features. Then why it is in column 12? It is not in column 12. I guess it is in column 11. Yeah, Arjandam. But still, I'll tell you why in column 11. Why too many? Because Arjandam's atomic number is 11, but the feeling is also not like 9. And if you feel that, you know, they are near to success, they are not near to success. They are successful, and they are not able to maintain the success. So, you know, Arjandam people, they are very good singers, very good public speakers. But what happens with them is they are not able to perform each time. So though you are a good singer, you have the qualities to sing, but after 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 concerts, you have this anxiety whether I will be able to perform same like my first concert or not. That is column 11. And 9 and 10 are very similar. So it looks like, you know, it's very near. That's not near to success. They are actually successful. And if you ask Arjandam patients, you know, for confirming the column, I generally ask this question to people that, do you... Okay. So what I was saying is, that, you know, or Arjandam, you have to ask the patient that, do you think that aap ye kar paoge, or whether you will be okay with the disease or not? This is a general question which I ask to get an idea, you know, where they feel they are. So generally, you know, the left side people will tell you, the people, you know, belonging to the left sided columns, they would tell you, No, I don't think so. I need a lot of preparation, and I need to go on and on, and I don't have the capacity. And people who are belonging to the right side of the columns or rows, they would tell you that I used to do this. I had this capacity, but now I don't have. That's the difference. Okay. So I hope I was able to convey you what is the theory of the columns and minerals and everything. So I would like to show you one picture, which says everything. So on the left side or on the base, you're just, you have started to prepare. And then there is a rising action. You are gaining the capacity slowly. And on the 10th column, this is called a summit column or climax. So that's a climax. You have the capacity or whatever you want to have. And then there is a falling action on the right side. That is after 10th up to 17th. Okay. So now there is some homework which I want to give you for this session also. I have told you already how to use rows and columns. And now in next session, what I'm going to do is I will give you I will show you some cases of mine, some cases of this will be a finale for this whole series, the fourth session, which will be conducted on Friday from 4 to 6 p.m. So very soon you will get the details and Zoom link, everything. So I will be showing two cases from my practice. I am going to invite two guests of mine, and they are also going to show you some cases of mineral kingdom, and you will understand, how to use this whole concept in practice and how to choose the remedies for them. Yeah. So I guess this will be very helpful for you. So today's homework is, so take one remedy from one column, okay? So one remedy from one column, and likewise you have to do 10 columns. So at least 10 remedies, and read all those 10 remedies of different columns. I am telling you, there are 18 columns. So you can choose any 10 out of them, and read those remedies from three different books and write down a summary. It can be on your computer, handwritten, or whatever. You just write down a summary of those 10 remedies belonging to 10 different columns from three different books based on that book which you are reading, and then correlate with that with the mineral symptoms. Okay? And send me the summary of 10 remedies from different columns, and also tell me your own experience of learning it. This will be really helpful for you. You will get new insights when you will do this homework. So you have to write down your feedback and your homework and everything. You have to send me on my email ID, rjyamini@gmail.com. And you can also visit our YouTube channel. Someone was asking about the YouTube channel names. That is Asha Homeo Health Center. Okay. And also you can visit our website. Okay. So is there any question? Yeah, Divya. So you're asking me to give an example for what? For homework? This one, I will tell you. Okay. So, yes, I'm telling you, I got it. Can you see Cholton's map? Yes. Okay. So, suppose you want to understand column two. Okay. So, this is column two. Can you see these numbers 1 to 18 on the top? And on the left side, there are also these columns, they are rows. So, you just, go to this, suppose magnesium. So magnesium belongs to column two, okay, and row three. So you have to read the magnesium from three different books. Say, I would read magnesium carb from Allen, from Borick, and from Fatok, like this. And likewise, you have to choose 10 different columns. So suppose I am choosing. I want to understand what is second column. So I chose magnesium. Then I want to understand what is sixth column. You choose molybdenum. If you want to study column nine, choose, rhodium or iridium or anything, or cobalt. Why I said 10 columns, not 18 columns? Because, few columns are empty. You won't get remedies there, and they are very rare remedies. So that will be, easy for you to just get 10 remedies and read about them. That will be easy. That's why I said 10 remedies. Is it clear, Divya? everyone. Yes, you can get the recordings of the session for sure. I will upload it on YouTube. Yes. So is it clear, the homework? No confusion at all? Very good. Very nice. So please do your homework. And I'm not saying you just send me this homework within 2 days. That's not possible, I guess. Everyone is busy. So I understand that. So you just send me this homework on by Saturday. If you send me by Saturday or even Sunday morning, on Sunday evening, I will announce who's the winner and who has done the homework very well and what gift you will be getting. So I will giving this gift to one person who has done all the homeworks. That's the case. And I have not replied all of you because I will reply you later. I will tell you what kind of homework you did and what you should improve and what was really nice. I will share the answers also. 15th date video. Yes, I will upload all the videos by mostly by tomorrow. You will get all the videos. Yeah, about the second day homework. Okay, so those who are there in the group, I will share it with you. You just, if someone doesn't know about the homework, you just send me a message. I will tell you that. I hope it was useful for you. Okay. And you got the concept? Very good. If you have any questions, you can let me know. Okay, thank you so much. I hope you have enjoyed it. And if you have any questions, you can write to me. I will send all the homeworks, Divya, for sure. You just message me, or I will send in the groups, the Homeopathy Junction groups. I will tell Dr. Vaibhav to send everywhere. Thank you so much and have a good day. Bye-bye.